I fight because it makes me happy. Nothing else really made me happy. Once I came to fighting, it really just made my life a whole lot better, and I've learned to love the community, I've learned to love the process and everything that comes with fighting. I love everything about it, and ultimately, I guess it could be a lot longer answer, but I fight because it makes me happy. All right, I came to Fairtex because it's a top-notch facility, and they're making noise. All their fighters are making noise on the world stage, on one championship, and making noise on the Thai circuit. So it seems like they're at the top of the game, and I wanted to see kind of where I stand, you know, because in the States we don't really have a good gauge of where our Muay Thai is or where we stand on the world stage. So I wanted to come and get that experience. And you know, I also wanted to try something different because I've been to Thailand before. I've been to other gyms and a little bit more smaller feel. And you know, it's just different being at Fairtex with so many fighters and being just with people constantly having fights and being booked, and you just see all the craziness and madness and all the work that goes into constantly being ready, being on call. And, being at Fairtex, I've learned a lot really, but narrowing down to a few things is, one thing is not really sacrificing power for balance. So my style is a very powerful style, I would like to say. Like, sometimes I like to be aggressive, I like to throw powerful shots, but sometimes I sacrifice balance. So when I came here, I almost felt like a novice learning balance and timing and rhythm and timing and balance. So going back and forth on that, things I teach to my beginners and back home is being taught to me. So that was very interesting for me to come here and be like, oh, I thought my balance was good, and realizing that I'm sacrificing a lot. There's been some really cool things that I've been learning technique wise. I've learned so much in the clinch because, you know, in the States we don't clinch as much as we do here, but clinching daily, you learned so many things. Again, going back to the balance thing, being tossed around by fighters that are maybe 110, 120 pounds that can just manhandle you, you know. So going back into clinch techniques and variations, those things have been amazing. And also I've learned what it really is to dedicate yourself to the sport completely. Versus home, we have so many things to balance. We have work, we have hobbies, we have family, we have all these things that we're constantly moving, we're hustling, we're grinding. And so even if you're doing it all the way, you constantly have a side project. So over here, I've really got to dive in and learn what it is to give yourself completely to the sport. So training here is very demanding. 6 days a week you're running. Most days I think it's like 6 to 7:30. We do a shorter run, and we also have a little bit longer of a run. We run up the hill behind the Pattaya City sign. So that's, you know, that in itself, you're starting off like really strong. And then from there we go into the gym, and then we crack pads at a minimum of five rounds of pads at 5 minutes a piece with a minute break in between. Then we have our bag work. It could be anywhere from like five, I'm sure other people do many more, like anywhere from 5 to 10 rounds on the bag, if not more, depending on how much time you have to wait. And then we do our body weight exercises. There's conditioning, some days there's sprints on other days, and there's just this kind of a variety of things to choose from on a weekly basis, I feel like. But regardless, you still train in the morning and in the evening at a 2 hour minimum. So if you're doing the pad work, the body weight exercises, the running, the clinching, everything that goes into getting ready for a fight, you do that twice a day. So it's very demanding, it's very tiring, but at the same time, it's very rewarding. I want to say thank you to all my sponsors: Golden Era, Mindful Meals, Hemp Generals, True Rest Napa, A-Game Media, and Movement by Design. You guys make my life a whole lot easier, so thank you for all your support. Thank you to my home gym, Phase 3, and all the gyms that help me around the Bay Area to help me get ready for my fights. I truly appreciate all of it. And yeah, stay up to date with me on my social media, Robinson Hoop, if I have it. That's what I'm on, R-O-B-B-I-N-S-O-N-W-H-O. Thank you, everybody.
Please like, comment,
subscribe,
and share.
Bye!